Good morning, students. In the previous class, we have studied about electric potential. How you define electric potential? The work done to displace unit positive charge from infinity to a point. That is called electric potential. And also, you studied about the expression for electric potential at any point due to an electric dipole. Today, we are moving to the next level of the chapter, that is called electrostatic potential energy of a system of charges. So there are many new terms in this phrase. First of all, you see this term, potential energy, that is a familiar term to you. From class 9 onwards, you are studying what is the meaning of potential energy. For example, there is a stone that is lying on the ground. The mass of the stone is M. You are displacing this stone by a height H, vertically upward to the top of the building. How much work you have to do for this process? You know, work done is equal to force into displacement. And if force is mass into acceleration into displacement. So the work done for displacing the stone is mgh. And what is this mgh stands for? That mgh is work done, that is right. And that is equal to the potential energy of the stone. So potential energy is a work done. Similarly, there is a spring. You are stretching the spring so that the length increases by x. How much work is required for this? That is what you studied in your class 11. Half kx square. Where k is spring constant and x is extension of the wire. And this is called potential energy of the stretched spring. So this potential energy of the spring is also a work done. Potential energy of the stone is also a work done. And here you can see you are displacing the stone. Stone is a small body. In the gravitational field of a bigger body, that is called Earth. Previous topics, many times we compare this idea with electrostatics. Instead of this source, Earth, we are having the source charge Q. And the small stone, instead of that, we are having the test charge Q naught. So, if you want to displace Q naught in the electric field of Q, work is required. And that work done, that is called, we define in the form of electric potential and as well as potential energy. Now potential energy, here one more word you can see, system of charges. What is the meaning of that word? This is origin, x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. Suppose a charge Q1 is located at a point A whose position vector is R1. Another charge Q2 that is located at a point B whose position vector is R2. Another charge Q3 that is located at a point C whose position vector is R3. Like that there are n charges. So which are the n charges? Q1, Q2, Q3, etc. Qn. Q1, Q2, Q3, etc. Qn. They are located at different points. Initially, you can assume that all these charges are at infinity. Initially, you assume all these charges at infinity. For displacing Q1 from infinity to A, certain work is required. For displacing Q2 from infinity to B, work is required. Replacing Q3 from infinity to C, work is required. So here, your system means it consists of many charges, more than one charge, located at different points. So Q1, Q2, Q3, Qn, that is a system of n charges. So all these n charges, they are located at different points. So initially we are assuming that all these charges are at infinity and you are taking the charges one by one from infinity to their respective positions. How much work is required for this process, or the total work done this process, that is called the potential energy of the system of charges. So what is the meaning of electrostatic potential energy of a system of charges? The meaning is this one: the work done to displace all the charges of the system from infinity to their respective positions in the electric field. Now we are going to derive the expression for this electrostatic potential energy. First, we will do it for two charges, Q1 and Q. Then we will do for three charges. By using that one, we will generalize. So the system consists of two charges. Initially, we are assuming that these two charges are at infinity. First, you are taking Q1 from infinity to A. The work done is W1. Then you are taking Q2 from infinity to B. The work done is W2. What is the value of W1? This work done is 0. Why work done is 0? That is a question. Suppose there is a source charge Q and the test charge Q0 separated by a distance R. You want to displace this Q0 by a small distance dr. You have to do a small work dw. How much work is required for this? This dw, you know, that is equal to force dot displacement. This is the actual formula. Force dot displacement is called work done. And your force is Q0 into E, because E is given by Q0. The Q0 is dot dr, means dr into cos theta. What is theta here? It is 180 degree. Why your theta is 180 degree? That is a question. Because the angle between electric field and which are the two vectors? One is electric field, the other one is displacement vector. Angle between electric field and displacement vector, you know, the direction of electric field is towards right side and your displacement is towards left side. The angle between them is 180 degree because they are in the opposite direction. So, for displacement, we need displacement is there, angle is required, electric field is required. If electric field is not there, there is no work done, just like friction. If you are displacing a solid body over a surface, you have to do work against friction, work against viscous force. Similarly, here you are doing work against the force due to electric field. Suppose this Q is not there, then this term is 0, your electric field becomes 0, and in that case your work done is 0. That is what is happening here. Initially we assumed that all the charges are at infinity. There is no source charge. That is why the work done to displace the first charge from infinity to A is 0. Reason is there is no source charge. Source charge is absent because all the charges were at infinity. That's the reason. Now we are displacing the second charge from infinity to B. Work done is 0. That is your question. Work done is not 0. Why work done is not 0? The reason is this one. You are displacing the second charge in the electric field produced by first one, because Q1 is not here now. Q1 is at A. Now this Q1 is acting as source charge and Q2 is acting as test charge. Therefore, the work done is there. So you are displacing second one in the electric field of first one. That is called W21. And how much work is required for this? You can use the same concept. Q0 E dr cos 180, or Q0 E dr. Otherwise, you can use one more concept. V is equal to W by Q. V is equal to work upon charge. So do the cross multiplication. Potential multiplied with the test charge. That will give you work done. So work done is equal to potential into test charge. Now what is potential? Potential is KQ by R. See, potential at a point here. Potential, electric potential is K source charge by R into Q0. So KQ Q0 by R, that is called work done. You replace the values on this expression. So K, there is no change. What is your source charge now? Your source charge is Q1. And what is the test charge? Q2. And what is your denominator? Denominator is AB. And that AB you can write modulus R1 minus R2. How? It is modulus R1 minus R2. You know OA plus AB is equal to OB. Therefore, AB is OB minus OA. You see this diagram? OB is R2 and OA is R1. The vector AB means R2 minus R1. Vector R2 minus vector R1. Now we need AB. AB is modulus AB. Modulus AB is modulus R2 minus R1 and modulus R2 minus R1 and modulus R1 minus R2. They are same. Vector AB is not equal to R1 minus R2, but modulus AB is same as R1 minus R2. So that is why this is W2. You take the sum of W1 and W2, you will get electrostatic potential energy of system of two charges. So your answer will be 0 plus KQ1 Q2 divided by modulus R1 minus R2. So this is the expression for potential energy of system of two charges. Now we can study the potential energy of system of three charges. And by using that one, you can generalize. Three charges means there is one more charge, that is Q3, that is at infinity. You are displacing Q3 from infinity to C. Position vector is R3. Q3 is here. Position vector is R3. Now see. Initially you assume all the three charges Q1, Q2, Q3 at infinity. First you are displacing Q1 from infinity to A. How much work is required? It is zero work because there is no source charge. Now you are displacing Q2 in the field of 1. How much work is required? W21. And the answer is KQ1 Q2 by modulus R1 minus R2. Now, the third one you consider. You are displacing Q3 from infinity to C. That means you are displacing Q3 in the field of 1 and you are simultaneously displacing Q3 in the field of Q2. Now W31, this is W21. So what is W31? It is KQ1 Q3 divided by modulus R1 minus R3 plus what is W32? KQ2 Q3 divided by modulus R2 minus R3. Now take the sum of these work done, that is W1 plus W21 plus third charge in the field of 1, third charge in the field of 2. You take the sum of all these work done, you will get your final answer, and that is called electrostatic potential energy of system of three charges. And that is equal to W1 is 0 and W21 is KQ1 Q2 divided by modulus R1 minus R2 plus W31, that is KQ1 Q3 divided by modulus R1 minus R3 plus K32, that is same as KQ2 Q3 divided by modulus R2 minus R3. This sum is called the potential energy of system of three charges. And you can generalize this. Before that, you write this one in another form. The same expression, you can write like this. K by 2 sigma Qi Qj by modulus Ri minus Rj. Sigma. You are familiar with the term sigma. Sigma stands for summation. Sigma I is equal to 1 to 3. J is equal to 1 to 3. I not equal to J. See. K by 2. Sigma I is equal to 1 to 3. Sigma j is equal to 1 to 3, I naught is equal to j, qi qj by modulus ri minus rj. If you want, you can expand and check whether this one and this one is matching or not. So I and j are not equal. For example, I varies from 1 to 3. So which are the possible values of I? Q1, Q2, Q3. If I is 1, what are the values of j? It may be 2 because I and j are not equal. Another one is Q3. I is equal to 2, j can be 1. J can be 2. If I is equal to 3, It may be one, it may be two. You can see there are six pairs, but in your answer only three are there. You can see Q1, Q2, that is repeated two times. Q1, Q2 is repeated two times. Q1, Q3, see, repeated two times. And Q3, Q2, that's also repeated two times. So we don't want repetition. That means we need exactly half of the terms, that is the k-byte. So this is a general formula for potential your system of n, system of three charges. If there are n charges, what is happening here? Here you have to write n. So this is the expression for potential energy. Electrostatic potential energy of system of n charges is equal to k/2. Sigma E is equal to 1 to n, sigma J is equal to 1 to n, Qi Qj by modulus Ri minus Rj, where I not equal to J. This is the final expression for potential energy of system of n charges.